Now we look at one phenomenon of light that is called dispersion. So far we have seen the reflection, refraction, radiation, so many things. Light is in the form of radiation. It does not require any medium, I said. So it's a radiant energy, in fact. And we have seen reflection, how a light ray falls on the mirror, reflects back, or any other surface reflects back, and how it refracts everything. Now we are going to look at what does it mean by dispersion. Dispersion is nothing but splitting up of light into its constituent colors. Splitting up of light into its constituent colors is called as dispersion. That means generally light is white in color. So that's the reason we call it as white light. So whenever a white light is falling onto a prism, here this is the instrument which we are going to look at in detail now. So what is a prism and all we'll be discussing. So if at all you have a prism and when a white light is falling on that, so with reference to the normal, this is the white light. So the white light is falling on that. When white light falls on the one of the surfaces of the prism, then it will get dispersed. It will get dispersed into its constituent colors. It will get dispersed into its constituent colors. That means you have the seven colors. So when it comes out in the form of seven constituent colors. And violet bends more compared to the red. So from violet to red, you are getting seven colors called vibgyor. So this is a pattern what you obtain. Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. So a white light when falls on the prism will get converted into its constituent colors, that is seven colors. And this phenomenon is called as dispersion. So, in simple, you can define dispersion is the phenomenon of splitting up of light into its constituent colors. Now, how it is getting dispersed and what the prism is doing over here and what is the purpose of considering the prism and what are the properties of prism, all these things we are to look at. And here, when you think about the prism, prism is an instrument where a light can get dispersed. That is the first point you need to remember. And using this prism, you can even calculate the refractive index of the material of the prism. That is the second point you need to remember about the prism. That means we are able to calculate the refractive index of the material. If prism is made of glass, then the refractive index of the glass. Prism is made of water, then refractive index of the water, and whatever the material this prism has, you can find out the refractive index. So this is one of the ways of finding out the refractive index. So earlier we have seen the refractive index formulae as velocity of light in vacuum divided by the velocity of light in medium gives rise to the refractive index. The other formula is due to the Snell's law. And this is one more formula where you can find out the refractive index. First of all, let us learn what is prism and what is its structure and the concerned parameters, what parameters we are to look into this prism, design of a prism. Actually, it's a three-dimensional aspect. So, in detail, when I look at the prism, so prism is a three-dimensional picture, so it appears to be like this. So the actual shape of the prism is going to be like this, and here it has got three rectangular surfaces A, B, C, A dash, B dash, C dash, let us say. So it has got, this is one rectangular surface, this is second rectangular surface, this is third rectangular surface, and two triangular surfaces. So one is ABC, this is one triangular surface, and A dash, B dash, C dash is the second triangular surface. So it's a three-dimensional picture of the prism, and the portion which rests on the ground is called as the base. So this is going to be the base. Base of the prism is this. So this is called as the base, and this is called as refracting surface. Refracting surface. So it has got two refracting surfaces. Two refracting surfaces. This is one more refracting surface. Two refracting surfaces and one base. So here it is made of. So in particular, you can write it has three rectangular surfaces, and here you can denote it as B, B dash, C dash, C, and A, B, B dash, A dash. This is one more surface, and the other surface is A, A dash, C dash, C. So these are the surfaces. In fact, you can call it as B, B dash, C dash, C, and again coming back to B. This is one surface, and here A, B, A, B, B dash, A dash, and again back to A. So this is one surface, and the third surface is going to be A, A dash, C dash, C, and again back to A. These are the three rectangular surfaces and two triangular surfaces. And that is ABC is one thing, A dash, B dash, C dash is one thing. So when you look at this in a cross-sectional way, the cross-sectional of view of the prism is going to be like this. So when you are looking at a side view, the side view is going to be like this, and this is what we call as A, B, C, whereas BC is resting on the ground. That is the reason you call it as BC. And now this is called as base. So this is the base, as I have mentioned over here. Opposite to the base, whatever the angle you have, this angle is called as angle of prism. This is the angle which is called as angle of prism, and you can also call it as refracting angle. So if it is an equilateral triangle, the prism is of equilateral triangle shape, A is treated to be, A is generally 60 degrees. So for equilateral prism, so this is the thing you need to consider when you are looking into the prism parameters. So using this prism, how to calculate the refractive index, all we'll be looking at. So here the summary of this entire lecture is that dispersion is the phenomenon where you are splitting up of white light into constituent colors, and that can be observed with the help of a prism. So when white light falls on one of the refracting surfaces from the other refracting surface, you are getting the dispersed light. And the structure of the prism is going to be like this. It's a three-dimensional view, and coming to the two-dimensional view, it appears to be same. And overall, it has three rectangular surfaces and two triangular surfaces. And a cross-sectional view of the prism is going to be like this, and various terms associated with the prism are to be in this manner. So this is how the prism can be described, and using the prism, how to calculate the refractive index, all we are to look into now.